has interacted with DNA. For example, acridine orange. There are many different types of intercalating substances. Acridine orange is one of them. What will happen? It will insert itself between two adjacent nucleotides. Suppose it intercalates over here. So this is what will happen. You can see now the distance between C and A, which was initially 3.4 angstrom. Now the same distance is stretched to 6.8 angstrom, and this part is the intercalating substance. Okay, now what happens when the next replication arrives? The two strands are going to be separated, where the intercalating substance is still there. The replicating enzymes are required to read the template and add fresh nucleotides on the opposite strand. So there will be an A over here, G over here, and then the enzyme is primed. Actually, the enzyme DNA polymerase is primed to add a fresh nucleotide at every 3.4 angstrom distance. What it finds over here is the intercalating chemical, the chemical substance which is totally unidentifiable to the enzyme. So what enzyme does is it adds any nucleotide out of the four, A or T or G or C, whatever nucleotide that first comes to the first comes handy to the enzyme is added over here. So let us identify that nucleotide as X, and then once again T and C. So we will have a DNA structure like this, A and G and X and T and C and T and C, and here we have the intercalating material, so A and G. Now at the next round of replication, when these two strands are separated, what will happen? A and G and X and T and C. This is a template. So what will happen? Against A there will be T, against G there will be C, against X, that is, it could be A or T or G or C, whatever. The complementary nucleotide, let us identify it as X prime. And then against T there will be A, and against C there will be G. So this is an additional base pair which did not present itself in the original DNA. When we look, how many base pairs are there? Only four, AT and CG, GC and TA and CG. And now over here, we have an additional base pair. So this is how the insertion has taken place. In a similar manner, we can also explain deletion, where the intercalating substance removes itself before the replication round starts. In that case, the deletion takes place. It is a process which is exactly opposite to the process of insertion. As a matter of fact, intercalating substances, especially acridine orange, are used very, very widely in many laboratories world over in the experiments of chemical mutagenesis. It is not very exaggerating to say that NTG, that is N-nitroso-guanidine and acridine orange, are two most widely used mutagenic chemical substances. We have in very brief tried to talk about the chemical basis of mutagenesis. Basically, there are many, many more mutagens of chemical variety. There are many more action mechanisms, how the chemical mutagens work. But it is not possible to summarize everything in a slot of hardly 40 to 50 minutes. So we have tried to make it very compact and very accessible to the students. We hope it would have served some kind of purpose to the understanding of students to the chemical basis of mutagens. before we come to the conclusion, if anybody has any question to raise, please. So, in that case, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.